Why are you watching it?
Cause this video. What's up, y'all? I got critical proof and evidence of what was yet to happen and what's happening.
Oh my god. Yeah.
Bink right there.
Here. You wanna be a
little. All right. I got critical evidence and proof that everybody knew what was gonna happen, including 50 Cent. Yeah, what's good, Mike? I can't wait to see you at the show, big doggy. But look, so, like I said, I don't really speak on 6ix9ine. And one of the reasons why I don't really speak on 6ix9ine is because I already tried to warn all y'all niggas, and I already told all of y'all exactly what it was and what was gonna happen. I already told y'all. So I don't really speak on this, but I've already told y'all. So, what I do want to state is nobody should be mad at 6ix9ine. None of the fans, listen to me. None of the fans, not only none of the fans, nobody in the rap game should be mad at 6ix9ine. Not a single person. And one of the reasons why nobody should be mad at him is he didn't blow up by himself. You know who we need to be mad at? We need to be mad at 50. We need to be mad at motherfucking Nick. We need to be mad at everybody who promoted. Mad at everybody who jumped on the bandwagon of a Mexican nigga with colorful hair.
He's Mexican?
Man, all that nigga. El Salvadorian, Dominican, Spaniard. Whatever he is. We can't be mad at nobody else but the niggas who helped promote this nonsense. But so hear me out. We can't, no, don't be mad at 6ix9ine. Don't be mad at no. We gotta be mad at the niggas that helped promote this shit. We gotta be mad at the niggas that made this nigga this big. And all the niggas that jumped on the bandwagon when the nigga got that big. So look, I'm watching this Uncle Murder video.
Right? Is it new?
Not as old. I'm watching this Uncle Murder video, right? Look, now just pay attention what's happening. Everybody doing all type of legal shit.
Oh my gosh, you freaked the hell out of me.
Casanova. Alright.
She's such a... He usually... Which one is he?
All right, this is where it starts. So everybody in the video doing illegal activities. This the nigga with the police. This nigga the only one with the police in the video. Pete, everybody doing illegal activities. This nigga is sitting on the police car, comfortable. Bro. He the only nigga in the video with the police. Peep. But not only is that, they shooting at him. They shooting at him. Everybody in the video is shooting at him for being with the police. Look, bro. They shooting at him in the police car. Bro. They trying to shoot him in the police car. This video was never a lie. This is the truth. This video was never a lie. You gotta think, this man really is in jail right now, cooperating, snitching on the entire New York City. He in jail right now, literally telling on the entire New York City. Look, let me tell you, I'm gonna show y'all right here. I'm gonna show y'all something. Show y'all valuable thing. You see all these buildings right here? All these niggas going to jail. That's the whole project right there. That's where all the trayways be. Everybody in this unit from right here all the way to the middle floor. Because you know all the old people live at the bottom because they can't really walk up to the top. But all the niggas at the top paying low income all the way down to about right there. All them niggas going to jail. Every last one of them. He snitched on the 9 trays over here, then the motherfucking 8 trays over here, then the little niggas that was hustling right here in this little block area right here, all them going to jail. Then the nigga that shot the nigga right here on Saks Fifth Ave, he going. Then the nigga right here on Lenox, he going. Bro. My guy is in the video in the police car while everybody trying to shoot at him. So my thing is this, right? Can y'all tag Casanova? Can y'all tag Casanova? Can y'all tag 50 Cent? 'Cause I got some questions. I need some answers. Can y'all all tag Casanova and 50 Cent? I got some questions. I got some answers. Can y'all tag Casanova, 50 Cent, and Casanova, 50 Cent, Nicki Minaj? I got some answers. I mean, I got some questions for y'all niggas. So, my question for Casanova and all these niggas, that was all a part of this. Uncle Murder, tag Uncle Murder too. My question for all y'all niggas that was a part of this. Looking back at this video, when y'all was filming this video, was y'all thinking about this? When y'all was filming the video, was y'all thinking, we gonna put this nigga with the police car because he probably a snitch? Or did y'all know? Did y'all know he was a snitch? And if y'all knew he was a snitch, then that means y'all niggas might be working with the people too. What's good, big bro? Hey, big bro, look at this, right? So we went back to this. Yo, I need all y'all to follow my big brother right there, David. It's my big brother, David Campbell. 54th Street. You know what that 54 stand for? Pablo. Nigga, my big brother out here running. Nigga, goons raised me. One big brother from Pablo, the other brother from Grape. Now what? Nigga, both sides of the projects. East side. Anywho. But look. Right. On some real shit. On some real shit. Hear me out. Big bro, I'm watching this video of 50 Cent, Uncle Murder, and Casanova, and all of them niggas. Right? And in the video, in this video with 50 Cent, Casanova, and all them niggas, they doing all type of crimes. But notice, 6ix9ine didn't do no crime in the video. He didn't do nothing illegal. He cooperating on the police car, sitting, having fun. He ain't do no crimes. Everybody else committing crimes, drive-by, shootings, all type of shit. He just sitting on the police car, laughing. Right? So look. I'm really thinking about this shit. I'm saying to myself, So look, people keep asking who was the police or who was the Fed. Him. The fuck? Him. This was a whole big investigation to take the whole nine trade ways down. They just did some shit like this to our homies out there in Jersey. Free Blizzy. They just did the same thing to the grapes out there in Jersey. Informing, snitched on everybody. Just did the same thing. Bro, he came out of nowhere with colorful hair. The man came out with colorful hair. The whole hood embraced him because everybody from the hood is stupid. You know what's so crazy? Let me talk some shit right real quick. Hold on, let me get it. Hold on. I can't really talk shit like this because I'm in my old school. Mama just got out the shower, did my hair. Hold on, I gotta switch this up.
Yeah, gotta look a little more gangster.
Hold on, cuz. Let me talk my shit, my nigga. On some real shit. Look. On some real shit. Hear me out, my nigga. Let me talk to you hood niggas. Let me talk to all you so-called gangster niggas. All you gangster. All you gangster niggas. All you super hood niggas. Let me talk to y'all. You know what's the problem with all y'all gangster niggas? Y'all really be embracing random niggas. This be the problem. What happened to, like, who you, where you grew up at? What happened to that? I remember when I was growing up, man, if you ain't, man, who is you? You ain't go to none of the elementaries, you ain't from over here. Who your peoples? Man, we don't care about none of that. You ain't from over here. Nowadays, niggas embrace anybody if they got a little bit of juice. They just let anybody say anything if a nigga got a little bit of juice. Just a couple of months ago, remember Soulja Boy and Chris Brown was big pyros, wasn't they? Just a couple of months ago, Soulja was in the fruit. Bro, just a couple of months ago, Soulja Boy and Chris Brown was Fruit Town Pyros. Yo, nigga went to the hood and damn near caught a fade with one of the homies. What? Bro, yo, I ain't really with the gangbanging activities, but I think I need to be from a hood. I need to get back in the hood and start creating some regulations. I'm about to find me a hood to get courted on. I want to be from like a Mexican gang or something. They're gonna call me a little tiny toker. Bro. They just doing anything in the game banging thing nowadays. Bruh. Game bangers. Bro, listen to me. Hear me out. An entire New York City notorious game banging crew got behind a kid with colorful hair. No, listen to me. an entire notorious New York gang got behind a kid with colorful hair and was like, we with this full-fledged. And then the nigga snitched on all of them. Bruh. What the fuck has happened to the rules of game banging? I remember if you lived two blocks away from the hood, your character thing was questionable. Niggas used to be like, where you stay at? Like, your hood be on, nigga, 112th. Where you stay at? 111th. Oh, you like an off-brand nigga. You ain't good over here. Bruh. Man, growing up where my thing was, man, you stay too many places away from the hood. Oh, nigga, you ain't really a thing. Fuck you talk about. Man, you if you, what? You stay where? Oh, yeah, he one of them. My nigga, I grew up on 103rd in Wilmington. I'm one street away from Grape Street. I grew up on 103rd in Wilmington. I'm a street and a half of Anzac, like a side street. I'm a street and a half away from Grape. I still gotta fight the green grape thing. Oh, nigga, daylight ain't really grow all the way up in the hood. Damn, nigga, I was in the motherfucker every day. Sheesh. You still gotta fight for your respect, nigga. I'm about a half a block away. I still gotta fight for my respect, nigga. Bye. Oh, nigga, you don't. Bruh. Now, my nigga. I'm from, bro, where we from, if you ain't grow up in the section, you ain't the reputable. We don't give a fuck how many, look, my nigga, I don't give a fuck how many people you killed, how many tattoos you got. Bitch, you didn't grow up in the section. You ain't from the set. Yo, you know what's so crazy about 69? This what y'all don't know. You know what's so crazy about 6ix9ine? It's 69 niggas going to jail. Did y'all know that? It's actually 69 people involved in this case. 69. No, actually it's 68. He was the 69th person that was involved in the case. And he might be getting out. Y'all ain't know that? Yeah, my voice coming back. Y'all ain't know that? 69. He was facing 69 years. Bro. That's all I'm saying. Look. All I'm saying is this. Y'all niggas be mad at me for trolling and doing all the wild shit. But I just do all of the shit I can so I don't be around these niggas. Because these the type of niggas that y'all worship and shit. These the niggas that get on radio and get all the play. So I love when people be like, I can't fuck with Daylight. He be doing weird shit. That ain't real nigga shit. Cool. That's cool with me. Because if these y'all so-called real niggas, y'all can have them. If these y'all so-called real niggas, niggas from Scotland and all that, niggas from Scotland, one nigga from Scotland, a nigga England, New Hampshire, wherever he from, The other nigga a snitch. Man, I don't know what's going on in this rap game. Y'all can have him. I keep doing all my weird shit and all my Vlad TV weird shit, Bradley's and all type of shit. I don't even want to be involved with you real niggas. I don't want to be nowhere near none of you so-called real niggas. I don't want to be involved. I don't want to be close to. I don't want to be by. I don't want to be nowhere near none of you real niggas. Y'all can have it. I'm out. I'm about to get in my Starbucks bag, nigga, with holy jeans, nigga, little Bugle Boy t-shirt, backpack, and a laptop. Oh, let me get a Starbucks, a caramel frat with extra caramel. I'm getting my Starbucks bag. I'm getting far away from the real niggas, because the real nigga thing, the real nigga thing looking like a joke. Man, my man 21 Savage from New Hampshire. Oh, my boy from Scottsdale. My man Irish. My man from the same spot, Leprechaun. My man 21 Savage from the same spot, nigga. That nigga grew up around four leaf clovers and shit. But look, man, look, when you a real nigga, you only could be from two places, the hood or Scotland. Fuck you nigga talking about. That's the only, you only got two options. Either you from the hood or Scotland, bitch. You got a musket at the house. You got the Pirates of the Caribbean pistol at the house. Bro. I look at 21. How many four leaf clovers you got? 21. My man got a musket. He gonna do a drive-by with the musket. That shit gonna take about 6 days to load. But, look, man. What I'm saying is this, right? All right, hear me out. I'm just saying, man. I don't want to be in the real nigga thing. I did a lot of things to get out of that. I don't want to be involved in the real nigga thing no more, because the real nigga world is taking hella L's right now. The real nigga world has took the most L's known to mankind. The real nigga world taking dummy L's, bro. Like, I'm talking about L's, ain't it, bro? The real nigga movement is a giant L. The whole real nigga movement is just a giant loss. Yo, real niggas don't do shit real. Niggas ain't got no businesses. Niggas ain't got no good credit. Niggas ain't got shit. Niggas, I'm loyal. Nigga, what? Yeah, you feel me? I'm real, nigga. I'm loyal, nigga. I never do nothing jeopardize my realness. What you talking about? I never jeopardize nothing to jeopardize my realness. But what you doing all day, nigga? I'm just real. Bro, you don't got no, like business plan? Nah, nigga. That shit ain't real. Yo, real niggas, idiots. Yo, you tell a real nigga, like, damn, nigga, what you doing all your life, nigga? Being real. Niggas be gonna be real to the grave, huh? Man, fuck you. Nigga, Steve Jobs wasn't a real nigga, nigga. Motherfucking Bill Gates wasn't a real nigga. Tesla, Einstein, none of them niggas is real niggas. I'm good, bitch. I'm trying to be a Edison, one of them. Nigga, fuck you talking about? I don't want to be. Nigga, every nigga that claim he was a real nigga is an idiot. Everyone. Every nigga that's real nigga, idiot. Fuck you nigga talking about? I'm trying to be, nigga, the square nigga. I'm trying to get the square money. Fuck that. Those all are real niggas. You know who a real nigga? Niggas like Bill Gates and all them niggas. Them real niggas. Want me to tell you why they real niggas? Because they do shit different. They ain't going to just kill you. You know what they do? They just gonna get a chemtrail plane spread right over your house. Your whole family gonna have the flu. They be fucking over niggas in a whole different type of war. They gonna do a drive-by with the flu on your bitch ass. And then they so cold, they the niggas selling you the medicine and all that. They gonna fuck over you. Look, bro. Look, my nigga, they gonna vaccinate your children, all type of shit. You gonna have autism, plenty of doctor bills, all type of shit. They gonna fuck over a nigga. Bro, that's a whole different type of motherfucking real. Them niggas doing all type of things. Bro. Look. On the real shit, I figured it out, man. Look, she said, that's not funny. She must got a kid with autism. Big dreamings. Why you say that's not funny? You got somebody with autism in your family? Or was you diagnosed autistic? You clearly sound offended. I need to know. You sound like something is triggering a thing in you. You must got somebody close to you with the thing. You must got a close member. Don't be scared now. Come on, tell us. If you got somebody in your family that got autism, let me know. Start a GoFundMe. I'll post it up and all that. Yo, people be getting all type of money for they fucked up children. Sweet. That's it. Niggas be getting all type of money. What? Am I autistic? Man, I'm diagnosed with all type of shit. Fuck you mean I was in double special ed? My mama had plenty of checks for me. I went to special ed. I was so fucking retarded coming up. I had after school special ed. You know, I needed an after school program. I had another special ed to go to after class. I was so motherfucking fucked up. Man, it was me and a ruler in the classroom. They had a ruler in the chair, like sitting up. Bitch, I was in the motherfucking, I don't know, I think they was doing like a test on me, like the movie Glass, huh? Man, look, my mama took me to something, because look, I'm going to tell y'all a real story. This might be kind of crucial for y'all. But look, so when I was younger, right? No, look, I'm about to tell y'all, I'm going to get y'all deep in my life real quick. So when I was younger, my mom and my daddy separated. Right, and when my mom and my daddy separated, like, I rebelled, because I was, like, very mad at what happened, so, like, I rebelled crazy, like, I'm talking about, I went ape shit, like, I'm talking about Dennis the Menace ape shit, right, my big brother, he ain't there to tell you, so, I rebelled, like, I'm talking about, man, I was burning the schools down, like, toilet paper on fire in the bathroom. Man, I remind you, I'm young. I may be in like fourth grade. I'm ditching school, hopping the gate, leaving. I'm catching the bus way to Normandy. I'm remind you, I'm in the fourth grade. I'm doing all type of wild shit, bro. Bro, I'm in the fourth grade, man. So they finally, man, we need to get this nigga evaluated. He doing all type of doing. He doing. Right? Yeah, my mama took me to like some type of little class to test my smartness thing. Right? So I was so much of like a troll back then that I was like, oh, all right, y'all think I'm retarded? All right, watch this. Boom. So they put me they put me in a little classroom and was like, can you draw a circle? I'm in the fourth grade, bitch. I shoot dice and all type of shit. You gonna ask me to draw a circle? Bitch, I just finished shooting dice. Fuck make you think I can't draw a circle? Y'all trying to play me. And I drew a triangle. Man, you niggas trying to play me. Man, I just caught the bus. I'm in the motherfucking fourth grade. I just caught the bus to Southgate. Bitch, you think I can't draw a circle? Man, I drew a triangle like a motherfucker, right? They come in there, what's that? And that's a circle. He looked at my mama like, we gonna have to take him to the other thing. So bam, now by this time I'm enjoying it because they giving the nigga all type of cheeses. Remember Cheesehead and all them? They giving the nigga all type of string cheeses, jellies, jelly, peanut butter, jelly sandwiches, all type of shit. So I'm fucking over all the candies and snacks. I'm playing plenty retard. Oh, give me more. I'm getting plenty of PBJs and all type of shit, right? So they was like, oh, it seems like he cooperates when we give him things, right? I was like, circle. And then they was like, that's a circle. I was like, yes. And then I looked at the dude to give me some more things, right? He gave me a handful of like little fishy chips. I fucked over. Right? I'm in there playing big retarded. I'm getting all type of things, right? So then I remembered, right? I remember my mom was on the phone with my auntie, and then she was saying, like, because I always had a very good memory. So I remember my mom was on the phone with my auntie, and she was talking that night. She was like, yeah, they saying he don't got it all. But, you know, girl, we could get a check. You know, our mama, yo, if you had a hood, mama, our mamas was, they was the ultimate hustler. She talked to my auntie, Bobo, you know, girl, shit. Shit, they say that check about 1500. Shit, we could get some couches. Yo, my mama already plotting. So I'm like, all right, well, shit, my mom could get the bag, nigga. I'm gonna go all the way in. Man, I went from a bad kid to he might be off to he fully retarded, right? And I get to the special ed thing the next day. I got the retarded limp and all that. Man, they looking at me like his symptoms are multiplying. His symptoms are multiplying. Right? I'm in there, man. Before you know it, they got me the little crutch thing, the little walker crutch thing. Man, I had my crutch thing and all. I was playing kickball. I was getting escorted around, pushed in the wheelchair. Man, I lived it up for the fifth and sixth grade. Fuck you niggas talking about. I was getting plenty of snacks. I was getting plenty of fishy snacks, nigga, cheese heads, string cheese, nigga, plenty of cupcakes, apple juices, nigga. Nigga, they was pushing me around in the wheelchair and all that, bitch. I was healthy as a bitch. Fuck you, nigga, talk about. I knew how to fuck over the system as a little nigga, bitch. I learned from the best. My daddy a hustler. I fucked over the system as a kid, bitch. Don't ever think I'm retarded. I'm gonna play the game. I learned how to play the game early. It's, that's a circle. Okay, what the fuck you talking about? Yeah, I'm a cold nigga. I'm gonna tell you how much of a cold nigga I am. Boom, so I get to high school, I get straight F's. Right? I get to high school, I get straight F's. I'm talking about F's all down the line. Like, nigga, F, 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 nigga. My shit look like Fast and the Furious. Right? I get F's. I'm talking about all the way to, you know, when you go to Jordan, they don't pass you anyway, bitch. They don't want your bitch ass to stay. Get out of here. You taking up space. So they gonna pass you anyway, right? So bam, I get straight L's. Boom, we get to the 12th grade. They like, oh, you wanna take the SAT? Oh yeah, why not? I smoked that bitch, 1600. It was like an anomaly. Wait, how he didn't pass none of the classes, but he smoked the SAT? Wait, what? Man, you think you gonna get me with these dumbass questions? If Jason was walking 2 miles per hour and he walked 3 miles, how many hours did it take? Bitch, man, click anything. Nigga, R. Nigga, fuck it. What's good, G? Bro, my nigga. Bro. I used to fuck over to school, bro. Right? Bro, I'm telling you. I was a dummy class clown. Stupid class clown. Nigga, as soon as I get in classroom, the teacher already... you know how they got the button in the bank? Or the little button under the thing like that? Man, my teacher had one of them for me. He had security on standby. So we had a teacher named Mr. Evans. He used to always sweat, right? He was like a sweaty-ass teacher. We get in the classroom, it's 7:30. Remind you, it's cold as fuck in the morning. What you sweating for, Mr. Evans? Boom. Bro, it's our first class. Bell ring, 8 o'clock. We get in, soon as we get in the door, sweaty-ass Mr. Evans. Get out, Mr. Campbell. Damn! Ain't got no speed stick? You steady using that bunk-ass white people deodorant in the gel one. Bitch, you better put some the powder on, bitch. You better go get some of that Dove. You know, we always use our mamas and girls' Doves. You know, we use plenty of sisters' Dove. I don't think I ever had deodorant, bitch. I go right in the medicine cabinet. Who Dove is this? Wham, wham. Bitch, I ain't never had no deodorant. I used the Dove my whole life. I don't give a fuck whose it is. I'm a real nigga from the hood, bitch. I don't give a fuck who Dove it is. Bitch, I'm using something. Wham, wham, bitch. Secret and Dove. Reg, no, that's why he laughed. He didn't use plenty of, he didn't use plenty of Doves. Only you gotta be a real nigga. You feel you know about the Dove. Bitch, nigga be like, nigga go right in the medicine cabinet. Oh, who Dove is this? Wham, wham, bitch. I don't give a fuck who it is. You ever went to a girl house, used her Dove? I know Reg has. I remember when I first was talking to my girl, when I first met her, she snuck me in her house, right? Her mama didn't want her to have a black boyfriend. So she snuck me in, wham. I had just finished playing basketball, so a nigga had like a sweaty weenie a little bit. I was like, I gotta use the bathroom. I went in the bathroom. I look straight in the thing. I need to find soap. Hold on, man, she had plenty of oil blades. Hey, and I wanted a nigga hike my leg up on the counter. Nigga squirt some oil valet in my hand. Nigga. Right? And then I said, oh, damn, I don't got nothing to wipe it off with. So, right? Right? So I'm so much of a project animal, nigga. So, you know how they got the towel hanging? I was like, if I use the front of the towel, somebody gonna see it. So I used the back of the towel and dried off, then laid the other part over the front. Like, they never knew. And I went back in the room with the clean weenie. Bro, when you from the hood, my nigga. When you from the hood, bro, you gotta have survival tactics. Red know all these stories because he did one recently. Facts. Bro, y'all don't know nothing about these hood things. I'm telling you, bro, nigga had all type of mind. Yo, I loved my life growing up, man. Like, as crazy as it was and as fucked up as it was the best moments of my entire life. Like, it was amazing. Like, yo, it was, like, really amazing. I wish I could do it all over. If I had a chance to be a rich kid, or go back to my broke thing, I'd be broke all over again. Bitch, I don't want to be no rich ass, depressed ass nigga. Oh, my father. Nigga, my fucking childhood was fun. Nigga, I remember going to my grandmother's house, but fucking by the Peplos, nigga. We used to be over there 100 deep, nigga. All the kids play hide and seek, nigga. Grandma whoop our motherfucking ass at that switch. Oh my God, I miss them days, dude. I miss my grandma. I'm about to cry a little bit. I just want one whooping again. Is that weird? I want a granny whooping. I miss my granny whooping to tear your ass up with that switch. Now come here now. What you crying for? I ain't even hit you yet. Pull your britches down. My granny used to whoop our ass in a nice, fashionable way. Pull them down. All right, squeeze your butt cheeks right there. She used to whoop us like she was like a professional whooper. Man, I remember one time she pulled a branch off the tree and grabbed the branch and slid her hand up the branch. All the leaves peeled off. That shit peeled off like a cartoon. Bro, she grabbed the branch. It was like hella leaves on it and all that. She grabbed a nice branch and just squeezed it and just all the leaves just came off. It was a clean switch after that. How you do that? Yo, I swear, bro. My granny was like a thing. Bro. I miss them days, my nigga. Well, get yourself in there, get you some watermelon. Yeah. My granny now was from, they was, my granny was at least by one generation from slavery. She never sailed. She didn't, there was no tea in watermelon. It was watermelon. Get yourself a piece of that watermelon and sit down. Yo, man. I miss my days, man, playing tag and shit, the hood, all type of shit, super soakers and shit, man. Y'all kids nowadays, y'all kids, bro. Y'all niggas will never understand what it's like to grow up in the 90s, bro. You know what was the best shit in the 90s? The Mario running pad. The Nintendo, you remember that? Oh, you ain't old enough, Reg. Nintendo had like a running pad, like they had the Olympic game, right? And instead of it, a controller, it's like it go into the controller port, and then the cable come to a big old pad that come over the floor. you gotta run on the thing to make the thing go. Like, it was like, bro, it was crazy. Nintendo had all, man, they had, do you know they had VR back then?
Yeah.
Like a Virtual Boy, that shit was making kids go up. Our minds wasn't ready for that type of VR thing yet. They had Virtual Boy back then. It was too advanced for our minds, so they had to pull it off the shelf. Yeah, you remember that thing. What? They had Virtual Boy. It was too much for us. They had to pull that thing off the shelf. But a VR ain't new. That thing been out since the early 90s. That shit ain't new at all. Y'all remember the Mario track and field? We had Duck Hunt and all type of shit, bro. My nigga. Sheesh. Anywho, I'm out to go, man. I'll talk to y'all niggas in the morning. I love all of y'all, man.